And so the world has gone and placed its weight upon your shoulder. And now the media is telling you that you're too old. It doesn't matter if your face gets homely. Just take it as a natural thing. And it doesn't matter if you get too lonely. Pour yourself a stiff one and just try to do your best to kill the sting.
Howdy, folks. We are the Aggressive Progressives. I'm TH.
I'm Rosie.
How you guys doing tonight? Boy, boy, boy. I tell ya, the stuff I'm reading in the news. Well, I'm not reading the news. I'm listening to the news. I can't read.
That's true.
I know.
Very illiterate.
I gotta tell you. You know, is there such thing as very, is there any more illiterate than illiterate?
Yes.
Very illiterate.
Donald Trump.
Oh, ooh, ooh, how you cast aspersions on my president. Anyway, so this is something that is in the news recently. Apparently, a conservative congressman in Montana body slammed a reporter from The Guardian.
Greg Gianforte.
Greg Gianforte, baby. Ladies and gentlemen, in the red corner, we got Greg Gianforte. Anyway. This guy from The Guardian, what's his name?
Ben Jacobs.
Ooh, Ben Jacobs. I want to hit that guy with that name.
Yeah, it's the beard.
You know what? I bet that guy got bullied in high school.
I imagine he did after saying that his spectacles went to heaven or something like that. It was really retarded.
If you didn't hear the audio, we're not going to play it. I'm sure you've already heard it. But
if you haven't, go check it out.
You basically are listening to a guy
whine about being body slammed.
Get the shit kicked out of him. Yeah, and it's audio, and he taped it, and he actually played it so that other people. I would hide that tape. How you get your ass beat by some old dude? You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Just got the shit kicked out of you, and you didn't do anything about it, dude, except whine.
Yeah, he's young and fresh, and this dude's been around the block and tired.
So anyway, he's like, "You broke my glasses, sir, and I'm gonna call the police." And I was just like, "You know what? You should have jacked that old dude. As soon as he did that, you should have jacked him."
Yeah, I mean, that was horrible, what happened and everything, and I feel badly for him. But then after seeing his video, I just wanted to say, dude.
You mean hearing the audio?
Oh, well, yeah. I saw his video.
You did? He's got a video, too?
Yeah, he has a video.
Are you kidding me?
Yeah.
Of him getting his ass beat?
No, of him talking about it.
Okay, all right.
So after I saw his video and I saw his face,
oh,
I thought,
oh my goodness.
He's just one of those guys, you know, that
he's
bring
punchable,
you there.
Isn't he?
He's very punchable.
He's punchable. Okay. I didn't know there was a video.
Oh, come on. You haven't seen the video?
Here's the thing, okay? I'm an avid believer. Dude, the congressman should not have lost his cool like that. But when you put yourself out in a public, position like that, you're going to get annoying reporters because that's what reporters are, folks. They are annoying. That is their job. So you have to expect your privacy. I mean, he was probably coming back to his office. I know he had someone with him, but he probably had to poo, something awful. He'd been holding it all day, waiting for this languid, long poo, and this young buck sticks a mic in his face. But that's what you expect. But on the flip side, if you're a reporter, one of the most annoying jobs, by the way, which can at least can possibly be, if you're a reporter and you're sticking a mic in somebody's face who has to poo, has to have to have dinner, you know what I mean, has been frustrated and so-and-so, you got to expect to get your ass beat occasionally.
No shit.
And seen. And mic drop, steps to the side, done.
I mean, if I was in that crowd, I would have wanted to see that man do something. You know, being body slammed and not and getting up and acting like, like a wimp. I'd eject him.
You'd eject him.
I'm just
going to
be honest here, and I'd have hit him.
I know you would. Anybody would have. Anyway, it's very disappointing. I'm sick of liberals getting their ass beat by, this whole violence.
By the way, Ben, spectacles don't go to heaven.
Did he really say that?
He did.
Oh, God. Obviously, I'm out of the loop on this. Boy, that once again, that guy's very punchable. Anyway.
Yes, he is.
Anyway, I'm sick and tired of liberals getting the shit kicked out of them by, conservative right-wingers and them getting away with it. That is probably what caused this guy to win Montana, folks. I want to stress, he won.
If he would have been an aggressive progressive, it would have worked.
Wouldn't happen. You know, you got to learn how to stick and move and
duck and dodge.
Duck to the side, exactly.
And
Ben,
just get one in.
Ben, don't roll with the punches anymore, dude. It's not working for you or your glasses. Anyway, so on that note, once again, we are not proponents of violence. We always have to say that for some reason.
I don't know. Maybe you haven't had enough wine yet.
I know. We're sitting here having a fine time drinking some wine, and then Ben comes up about getting his ass beat again.
I think you've had enough.
I have had enough. Anyway, we are the aggressive progressives, and we're just trying to let you know, as liberals or progressives, stop taking shit and flack from the right, you know?
It's a real major problem. Let's just be honest.
Grow some balls, folks. Ben, we love you, my man. We love you.
Thanks for reporting.
Absolutely. Absolutely. And good luck to your glasses in heaven. Anyway, we are out of here. Subscribe to us. If you want to see more of Ruthie, look down in the description below to her Patreon page. She's absolutely gorgeous. I'm telling you. Anyway, thanks a lot, folks. We'll be back with more. Say goodbye, Ruthie.
Later. Help you get to set an emotional picture.